Hello, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Welcome to this lecture. The lecture is entitled Introduction to Time Series Analysis. So this lecture is an introductory lecture about time series analysis, and we will not go in details about time series analysis. We won't be doing practicals. What we expect is some basic understanding of time series analysis. Let's go to introduction. A time series is a sequence of measurements which is equally spaced through time or along some other metameter. So you can see sequence measurements and equally spaced through time. So what's wrong if we do regression analysis for time series? The issue is that the key assumption of regression is that the outcome measures are independent. And this is not true in time series data because observations that are close together in time tend to be correlated with one another. For example, weather for today is correlated higher with weather for tomorrow, and weather for today is less correlated with weather next month, and weather today is much, much less correlated with weather next 2 or 3 months. So because of this dependency of observations, the standard methods of inference for regressions are therefore not valid. If you remember, one of the assumptions of linear regression is observations are independent. There is also issues of seasonality. For example, if we look at this figure is number of live pregnancies per week. So week range from week 0 to week 150. So this means the data is a 3 years data. And you can see there is a trend of less live pregnancy over the 3 year period. And within each year, there is oscillation, or which indicates seasonality. For this may be for the first year, second year, and third year. So you can see there is a trend, and there is also seasonality. And you can see that the trend is that the weekly number of pregnancy is decreasing. And the number of pregnancy in a week may be negatively associated with the number of weeks before, right? So if you want to further study the correlation, we can examine the correlation coefficient. For example, in figure 2, for the birth data just now, we measure the correlation and graph the correlation against the lag. The lag is the difference of the time of observation, right? So you can see that this part, the correlation is high, but as the lags got bigger, as the observation go further apart, the correlation decreases. So the correlation coefficient between the number of pregnancy for 1 week and the number u weeks later against the lag u from lag of 1 to lag of 20. So this autocorrelation function, or in short call as ACF, you know, it demonstrates that the observations in time series cannot be assumed to be independent. So it indicates dependent observation, and because of that, it violates most of the standard statistical analysis. If you have a time series data, what you want to do with it is to perhaps provide simple description and then proper explanation why such series is observed. You can make prediction, and you can also control for difference in the covariates, adjusting for confounding effect. You have univariate time series and multivariate time series. A univariate time series, again a sequence of measurements against of the same, it is collected over time, and of course the measurements are made at regular time interval. So the term univariate time series here refers to time series that, number one, there is only one dependent variable or observations. It is recorded sequentially over equal time increments. For example, if we look at this data set, you can see the measurement of carbon dioxide from 1974 until 1976, taken at 1 month apart,